know, the people of America are deeply interested in India. I send you my cordial greetings on behalf of the Muslim India, and I feel we have your good wishes. As you know, of the many races, creeds and religions that inhabit the vast subcontinent of India, there are two major nations, the Hindus and Muslims. 100 billion of Muslims cannot be characterized as a minority. We are 70 million in the northwestern and northeastern zones of India. We constitute a majority of 70% against the caste Hindus in these homelands of ours. We want the division of India into Hindustan and Pakistan because that is the only practical solution which will secure freedom for both Hindus and Muslims and the achievement of stable and enduring governments of Hindustan and Pakistan, which I am confident will settle down as friends and neighbors like Canada and the United States and other sovereign states, both in North and South America. Hindu India and Muslim India must be separated, because the two nations are entirely distinct and different, and in some matters antagonistic to each other. Let me tell you some of the differences. We differ in our history, culture, language, architecture, music, laws, jurisprudence, calendar, and our entire social fabric and code of life. One India is impossible realization. It'll inevitably mean that the Muslim will be transferred from the domination of the British to the caste Hindu rule, a position that Muslim will never accept. As an all-India minority, we shall be under the rule of the permanent Hindu majority of about 3-1, which will virtually mean one nation ruling another by means of Darij Bond. The writ and fiat of such a government will neither command respect nor acceptance and allegiance, and such a government will therefore be impossible. It can only function by force. It will never secure the willing approval and sanction of the 100 million of Muslims. Unless the gravity of this aspect of the problem is realized and tackled frankly and boldly by the British government, chaos is inevitable, which must have serious repercussions and endanger the world peace. Our scheme of division of India gives Hindus 3/4 of the country, and the Muslims secure a dominant voice in the remaining 1/4 of India, thereby giving the two nations hope and opportunity to develop in accordance with their own culture and ideology, so as to contribute to the peace and advancement of the world as a whole. Muslims desire freedom more than anyone else, because love for freedom, fraternity, and liberty is the lifeblood of their existence. But freedom must mean freedom both from the British exploitation and Hindu domination. 100 million of Muslims will never agree merely to a change of masters.